Alright, time to see what reward the Gaul Village has for the big hero. Better be something good. Good rescuer. I like the sound of that. I am a good rescuer. Even though it was Tav who did the actual rescuing. I helped. Alright, buddy. What you got?
Thanks to your ladder and my handiwork, everyone's back safe and sound.
Sorry, I told you the Rubbler was guarding a big treasure, but you wouldn't have gone if I hadn't told you that. As an apology, Gaul will give you a good thing. Go across the lake and raid our treasure house. Go, 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 go.
Well, treasure always makes it easier to forgive. I suppose I can accept your apology. This time. Say, you can help me in another way. I want to get to the other side of these caves. Can you tell me how to get through?
Know the way? Gah. Of course God knows the way. You must enter the big door in the Cave of Wind. We keep the door locked always, but the key's in our treasure house. Take, take, take.
Lousy, dirty, rotten, stinking liars. Heal me, Doc. Even though you're not a doctor. And if you are, you're the shadiest looking doctor I've ever seen. Remember that door? The blue one a long ways back that we couldn't open? Yep, that's the one the creature was talking about. Hey, a fish. Can't eat it. Oh, come on. There we go.
Take these for getting us out of that fix a while back. Take them. Go on. Take them. Y'all expect me to give you now? I done give you my best bananas. I ain't got nothing left. I give and give and tain't ever enough for you city folk. Save me from a fix and you think you own me. Well, let me tell you something. I ain't never been nobody's slave and I ain't fixing to start now. So just enjoy the bananas and leave me be.
Man, that thing sure is uppity. I mean, jeez. I didn't even want more bananas. I just wanted to be friends. Wait. Wrong way. I got lost. Wait. Damn it. Looked exactly the same inside as it does outside. Except there's more fishies. Old man. And the freaking key. God damn it. All that work for 1,000 gold and a key. Oh well. At least now we can continue our quest. I guess I might as well sell the gold stuff while I'm here. Although I could have sold it in the shop down there, but it doesn't matter, I guess. And we are $1,500 richer. We are a full game of Monopoly richer than we were before. Alright. Time to go all the way back to the Wind Cave. Whoa! I don't think so, fish. You can't get me that easily, fishy. Ow! Freaking jellyfish. Jellyfish do not work that way. I think I need to get up on that bridge up there. Oh, screw you! I landed on top of you, you freak. You freak of nature. You damn mutant jellyfish. I love the sound effect it makes when you fall for some reason. It sounds so out of place. Sounds like a sound effect from an Atari game. Bloop. Sounds like the sound your paddle makes when break out. Alright, get over here, you stupid jellyfish. I need you. Oh, lordy. The day I start relying on jellyfish is the day I am not a very happy Duke. I had a dream once that I had a pet jellyfish, and for some reason, it didn't need to be underwater. Like, it could fly. Kind of like I was in SpongeBob SquarePants. Because they're technically underwater, even though you never really notice it. I mean, they, like, build fires underwater and stuff. Yeah. They build fires underwater, and gravity works exactly the same way. And the jellyfish just kind of fly. I had a dream like that once. I love that jellyfish. I was so disappointed when I woke up and I didn't have my very own jellyfish to hold and cuddle and call George. George the Jelly. Oh well, I have a cat. That's almost as good. I mean, I guess the benefit is that cats can survive above water, and they don't have poisonous tentacles. That reminds me, when I was a kid, I had a newspaper route, and somebody had this cage on his front porch, one of the people who I delivered to, and he had a hedgehog in it. It was a caged hedgehog. And there was a sign on it that said, "Do not touch. The hedgehog is very poisonous." And I was like, what? I mean, first of all, who would touch a hedgehog, even if they aren't poisonous? And second of all, that was the first I ever heard of hedgehogs being poisonous. I mean, I thought they were just spiky. I thought that was their defense. That was before the days of Wikipedia, so I couldn't look it up. I guess I should look that up now. Maybe I should ask Jeeves. Are hedgehogs poisonous? I mean, I guess maybe they have poison in their spines or something. That seems kind of redundant. And we finally made our way to the hot springs. Time for a freaking mud bath. Oh yeah, the enemies here are a pain in the ass compared to the enemies before. These bats take 3 hits to hit kill instead of 2 like the other ones. Ow. These things do a ton of damage. But this is also when the gold collection starts ramping up a little bit. Then you have these skeletons, which are freaking tanks. Is this the way I want to go? I don't even know, man. Yeah. Whoa! Shit. Oh, god damn it. Player tap, player tap. There. What's this say? Monster Mart. Interesting. Is the Monster Mart down or to the left? To the left. Let's see what they have to offer. I have a little bit of time. First of all, why would monsters sell to humans? That doesn't make any sense. Oh, it's those monsters. Oh, yeah. I guess I'll switch back to male. Man, that's a close call. Heal me, my brother. I already have that stuff. What's your problem, man? Did I equip all this stuff already? Yeah. I thought I did. Yep. Same old crap. Is there an item shop or just a weapon shop? Oh. You're friendly. A weird elf kid. Oh no. I think that's a cutscene coming up, so I will cut it here. See you tomorrow on Let's Play Popful Mail. Duke of the Bomb. Good night.